Kevin Costner and sports movies are meant to score together, with classics like Bull Durham, Field of Dreams, and Tin Cup. Draft Day, however, is not destined for that particular Hall of Fame.
We talk football?
We can always talk football.
I just want the team that I want one time.
You see things other people don't see.
Directed by Ivan Reitman, Draft Day plays like a cheerleading infomercial for the supposedly historic trades of the NFL's annual sweep. Costner is Sonny Weaver Jr., the down and nearly out general manager of the Cleveland Browns. He's desperate to make a stadium-filling trade at any cost, restoring his pride in a city that believes it all but invented football.
I need 5 minutes and then you can fire me.
I got Shawn Michaels on the line.
Sonny, are we trading six?
I quit, Sonny.
Don't quit. See what I do from here. You're gonna like this.
The story is at once authentic and also bogus. There are familiar faces galore from the NFL, including a speaking part for Commissioner Roger Goodell, and also the ESPN and the NFL Network. But the war rooms of these mostly male traders are more vanilla than Viking, and some of Sonny's more dramatic deals are dubious, to say the least. Estrogen is also sadly lacking. Though there are more assertive women than Costner normally deals with in any sports movie, they all spend more time on the bench than on the field.
All that matters is what you think. Write your own story, Sonny.
When Draft Day finally grabs the ball and runs, the excitement level also rises and you want to see how it ends. For the most part, though, a player criticism expressed by one dealmaker also applies to the film. Looks like Tarzan, plays like Jane. For thestar.com, I'm Peter Howell.